or Ikolanoti. Because they were used to tobacco company financing their agricultural investments, unlike the other ones. So it was important that they did that. And that is why it is, you still see some companies doing it. In, I think Leventis has a farm somewhere for some kind of inputs. Can't we also, Unilever also had a palm oil something in those states. So those are the kind of strategies we are talking about. Of course, we have some primary and secondary stakeholders. Here you have your customers, those who will take the end result, or who bail you out, those who will give you money for the value you are offering. They are essential, they are primary and secondary. And if you look at what I've said, you will not see misconceptions in our stakeholders mapping and management. Because once as communicator, you say, what are your stakeholders? Who are the most important? You say, your primary stakeholder, isn't it?
It's not.
Primary stakeholder is number three in the scheme of agenda. Is a primary stakeholder because he is a beneficiary. He's a beneficiary, he's a customer, which is very important. Then, also, it can be your employees, which is also very important. Employees, customers are in that class of primary setting. And of course, the second thing will be those who are also important, like the environment, the government that takes care of the lighting, the infrastructure that gives you, of course, the tertiary work, which are the regulators, for example. So these are the kind of things we need to look at. So if you look at the diagram there, you will see that I reposition what you think they should be. You see community and employee very close. Because the employees come out of the community in most cases. At least the largest percentage of the employees must be from this community. Then owners, most of them also are consumers, and then the funders. These funders, owners, and these people can kill the company overnight. Any of this. If there's a consumer boycott, like 1997, there was somebody who found cockroach in a bottle of 7-Up.
I did this thing.
And for yes, a whole week, nobody
packed.
7-Up was down for it.
Added the
2004, UBA, Unilag branch.
Writing a book and that's
somebody went there to get money and they said they should wait for one or 2 days. I think there was cash trap. Generally, it was general then to not the bank. But in Unilag, which was an academic community, a professor, C.S. Norman himself, the then dean, faculty of arts, came up to collect about 40,000 and he couldn't get his money. He said, faculty money. At this age, they now say, I have embezzled money. No, I must get my money. Then he said, there was no money. Before you knew it, everybody queued up at UBA to collect their money. But they don't give me money. It is worse today because of ICT. It is worse. Reputation management has become more delicate, more dangerous. Yesterday there was a broadcast on social media that somebody escaped from TB Joshua's church. I went to the general hospital and they said, don't get near the hospital at all. God save that hospital. So, the power of spiral communication. So we must put them at the very correct place. Look at the regulator. And where it is on this side is image police, government and regulator, and also mass media and social media, image police. That's what they do. Before you say, well, journalists, the progressive of them, we are the mouthpiece, the absence. Even before journalists, there are professional and ordained, nobody sent them who are journalists. My daughter was showing me a picture yesterday, a policeman putting gun on his laps and they slept up snoring.
Yeah.
And he said, police is your friend. So it is important that we know stakeholders management process. I just simplify it, it may be more complex than this in the, your own situation, depending on where you are. But you must identify the stakeholder that you have done. You must also plan stakeholder management. One size fits all is a misnomer, and it can confuse the leadership. It can also give wrong impression. It can give you a very false result, and it can also throw you out of your job as a communicator. And this is the reason why majority of our colleagues do not go beyond supervisory and middle management level, because they cannot influence policy. They cannot actually get right the identity of the stakeholders. They cannot classify them into where they belong. And once the board level and top management see that you don't do that and you don't know it, they won't tell you. All you do is that you just discover that communication manager does not go beyond senior manager level. Between 1965 and 1985, no bank in Nigeria had a corporate affairs manager who was up to AGM level. The highest level was principal manager. Go and find that. I am telling you of what I have been through. 65 to 85. Nobody in the banking industry. And when you found them after 85, having AGM corporate affairs, they were all bankers, chartered bankers, not communicators, not journalists, not PR person, not marketers, not advertising. But they just wanted that name. But they believe all what corporate affairs should be doing is customer relations. And then they started the discipline of customer relations officers. People, beautiful girls in skirts and beautiful cars coming to knock your door and talking about deposits. Yeah? The forum era. Everybody come inside. You forgot it. But the banking industry today has been challenged beyond that. And they have found the necessity to have very robust, attractive, and impactive media and platforms where they should be able to convince, disseminate, and also, of more importance, inflow, which is the feedback loop. The difference between feedback and information is that information does not receive. That's why government use information officer, information officer. They are not expecting feedback from you. They are dishing it out and throwing it to your throat. Pay your tax, so your tax is 2,000 naira. They are not expecting you to negotiate. So it's just information officer they need, not communication officer. But in the private sector, you need communication officer because the man will show, okay, when are you likely to pay your tax? Well, it may be January, but our own kind of business doesn't come until it is December. Then you now put down those to pay tax by January. The feedback is now used for replanning. That's one of the reasons why government fails in most of their projects, but there's no room for feedback. But you can see that some government organizations are now changing. I gave kudos to Lagos State Government. For the first time in history, 2007, I got a letter from the Inland Revenue Lagos State to congratulate my organization for paying tax promptly and regularly. Yeah, I was surprised. I asked my colleagues, put it in the boardroom, frame it, and put it in the boardroom. It has never happened before. That shows you that government is recognizing feedback importance. And any communication to stakeholder that does not allow for feedback is going to die like Xerox. You remember Xerox?
Yes.
Xerox was economy very successful, making monster machines as big as this room that 1,000 people will make photocopies within 1 minute. Good idea, but we must all leave our jobs in respective offices and come to the copy center. How many of us remember the copy center at CMS during the one regime? Bookshop house under the staircase, very big. Then we all queue to make photocopies. Those of us who are messengers in the ministry, young boys, then with our brand can queue to make photocopies. But Cameron said, "What a stupid idea! we can give you something on your desk like this, and you make your own photocopy yourself. So the money to buy 100 of this machine is not up to the money you are going to buy a whole one of Xerox. And people say, try it, let us see. And then they push it out and get the feedback. Before you know it, Xerox died overnight. And Xerox was a real monster. You cannot make photocopy on Xerox machine with another. It has to be Xerox paper in Xerox machine. But I cannot say, use any paper you like, make photocopy, just go ahead. Break the rule. So that is the challenge. So communicators must know when your stakeholder demands are changing, you must change. Many organizations are like deaf riders of horses. When the horse is not deaf, but the rider is deaf, the horse will be doing the right thing. The master will be cautioning the horse. You get my analogy. If you are a deaf person, you are doing a polo race, and the referee is blowing on, you know, your horse will be obeying the rule. But if you are not comfortable, you will not be telling the horse to do a different thing entirely. Because you are deaf. So if the horse is deaf, but you are not deaf, it is worse off. Because all the beating and whatever you are doing to the deaf, you just don't understand. So you find yourself where you don't want to go. So if the organization is a deaf to communication, the PR or communication person is wasting his time. If the communication person is deaf and the company is ready to go, the PR man will be thrown off. Because we don't need to do so. So it's not, either way, it's not okay. That is why you need to engage. You need to engage and control your stakeholder. How do you engage your stakeholder as communicators? Many of us, we don't know what you call entry level when you are entering any organization, whether at lower level or upper level. It is important for you to understand the nuances of entry level. I will demonstrate one or two so that, because this level is important to the majority of us I see here. As I can see here, 60% of us here, if not more, are still working for organizations or individuals, while others may be having their business. So it's important for you to really understand the nuances of entry point. Whether you leave your organization to do another one, or you are elevated from your present position to another one, you cannot be using the same standard. That is why, when you are moving, any organization that doesn't know the difference will not know you need a transitional course to move from a supervisor to a manager, from a manager to top manager, top management to board level. There are different journeys entirely, and they require different kits when you want to go on that journey. So for a PR person who is working at very middle or lower level, you will find yourself under admin director, in most cases, or somebody they call development, director of development. There are so many funny names you find yourself under as a communicator. Once there is no communicator at the board level. Am I lying? All sort of. It can be anything. I don't know whether anybody wants to share some stuff. Your boss, where you are, PRO or manager corporate affairs, who are you reporting to?
GM Corporate Services.
Yes, GM Corporate Services.
GM Lega.
Yes, GM Lega, yes. Lega, yes, yes. Human resources.
Yes.
Some report to human resources. Some report to marketing manager. Some report to office manager. General duties and administration. GM. General duties. Anything goes. Then they want to buy roasted plantain. You are there. The first thing is to change your value chain. You must create it yourself. Value chain must be created. Create your own value chain. Nobody will do this for you. I will show you two examples of my own personal experience. A hospital started in 1990, and the three directors said they never needed anything public relations or marketing because in medical service in Nigeria, you are not expected to advertise. So what are they going to do with journalists or PRs? But I told them, can I be allowed to submit a proposal? And demonstrate the proposal for 1 month. Don't pay me anything. I take a lot of risk, and it has really helped me in life. They look at it. What is this young man saying? Don't pay me. But let me show you a page, and let me use the page. And I showed them a page. And the first thing I did was to do, ask for free health check. 1 hour every Friday for the first 10 executives that come home. So what do? We write letters to anybody from AGM level in the bank, because you must call those who can afford the services of the co-hospital. So from every 10 AGM levels from banks that will come for free health check, somebody's eyes will be bad, you will take glasses. Somebody will have diabetes, you will be hospitalized. Somebody's sugar level will be too high. Something must be wrong with them. The first thing that we found out in month one was to actually have 26 people admitted for minimum of 2 days. We now found that free health check became source of feeding the hospital beds. Genuinely, not pretending, not falsifying it. Because people are careless about their health. Even, it's even better now. 20 years ago, 15 years ago, it was worse. Executives don't have time for their health. I remember the bank industry. They were all from, you know, it was bank's money, free service. So everybody wanted to spend the money for its own good health. So we were denying them, canceling them, and all the parastatals of federal government. NITEL, NIPOST, must mention them, all of them. They were talking about the first original clientele of the hospital. Because the individuals on the sick cannot afford it. So by the time they saw what was coming, we increased it. We had executive bedrooms upstairs where you can do your bed rest. It's like a five-star hotel, but they still have it. You call for your own meal. A nurse stands by you all day to your own attention. Exclusive service. Television is there. Fridge is there. STD is there automatically. Then you have your warmers, the microwave, everything. Then you have your kids going to go and play. Then affiliated to clubs where you can play tennis and so on. People were choosing to come there. And it was a miniacle tourism. When God wanted to help me, Major General Watchbu came there to do minor operation for his leg. You know we shouldn't advertise. Then on Sunday evening, I was able to secure the cooperation of two newspapers that put it in the front page. IPP visits Nwachukwu at a hospital.
Oh my God.
Was that advert?
No.
His colleagues, his subordinate to say, are you very well? Just to let you know that it's not a hospital, it's treating ministers. So they don't need to travel abroad again. And head of state at Sapuda is a good hospital. That's why he even came. To see his own subordinate. Full stop. No advert. So the reputation building of the hospital started and gradually it was going off. So it was not about surgery, it was not about bed two of one operation or the other. No, it was about impacting on the key stakeholders. You must actually go for the topmost of your stakeholders to build reputation fast. If you want to build reputation fast, those who are key mostly to your own enterprise, those are the first class people you must run after. You must know that that is the engagement you need. Then you need to control it. How do we control it? You must lock door against your own priority, against your own best property. Your reputation is your property. If you allow it, and now you to have access. Once you come to a co-hospital as an executive and you have discipline, they give you platinum card or golden card. Then you can tell you the last one of the family. Sorry. When we come here free of charge. No charge. So if another computer wants to do, let him try whether he can do it. Do you understand? There must be something to lock the door against your competitor. There must be something to bind you and your stakeholder to yourself and saying, no, we are not detachable, you can't go elsewhere. So that is the 5 and 6 strategy. You must build it in your reputation management. It's very key. Well, growing importance and acceptance of reputation and stakeholder, this is very straightforward. Reputation is becoming a key source of competitive advantage, no doubt about that. Products and services become less differentiated. In the petroleum industry, the petrol sold by Texaco and Mobil, are they different? What is different? The branding and location. So if I drive into Mobil and say, okay, come and open your auto, your tank. Okay, calm down, now come and open. Then I enter Texaco and say, I like your t-shirt, this is fine. No, don't worry, I'll open this. Please, can I just help you clean this glass a bit? It's dirty. Yeah, what was? I'm not talking about the fuel you have come from. Look at this soon. You don't know when your tire just step on this, what are you going to remove for you? Hey,
peripheral treatment.
They say, hey, how much fuel you want to buy? Where will you go to volunteer? This is only different. The personal product are the same. And that's why the Lagos women, they that are illiterate, are to do with your market. They tell you, give you the same price. Come and do what? Come back and do what?
Buy from us.
Don't buy where you find it to. Even when it's the same price. Come here and do what? Come and buy from me. Why? She wants relationship, continuity. Because she's selling two things. The product and then relationship. And the envelope, you want to pack it into this continuity envelope. So come tomorrow, come the after tomorrow. So the same simple approach of us. Companies own their brands. The stakeholders are the ones who build their reputations, appraise and pronounce verdict, which determines corporate success. Yes, you can have a very good product, very, very good, wonderful. And it is the stakeholder that will pronounce the verdict, that will either make sure that it remains there forever. What is in Coke? What actually is the big deal in Coca-Cola? Can somebody who's an addict here tell me? what is actually the thing? You cannot see in any other product. You just discover that you cannot just rest on my food. But I said that you cannot tell anybody what is fantastic.
It's different.
It's just right. Just like 18 years ago, I stopped using sugar. I take my tea with milk and no sugar. The first few days, it was like I was eating poison. But today, I don't know the difference. His taste is in your mind. We did blind testing of Coca-Cola so many times in my MBA class. We will put Pepsi in plastic cups. I will say 20 people drink. No Coke at all, Pepsi only. And when so those of you believe you drank Coke, raise up your hand. 15 will raise up your hand. It is the stakeholder that pronounces the verdict that makes or mar your reputation as a brand. And that is why, rather than getting busy managing the chemistry of the product, you better manage the chemistry of the reputation of the stakeholder and relationship between you and them, the stakeholder. Stop. And that's why the chairman of Coca-Cola said, Coca-Cola is your brand, though. We are only doing what? We are only managing it for you. We have no business in it. It's you who own it. But he knows where the money is going to. Is it your pocket that the money is going to? Stakeholders have unbreakable chain of solidarity and loyalty, jointly and individually. That's one funniest thing about brands. 1962 to 67, there was one very powerful advert of Mobil. Pam, pam, make it Mobil. It came back again 3 years ago. Children on the streets who had no car. Child of age 7 and 10, which car would they have? But once they say, Papa, you have the child, make it Mobil. all over Lagos, everywhere. It was like nothing else. Nobody was saying anything else. When you say papa, just like me, no. Me, no. Papa. It is even people who are not taking me. Children and parents could not afford me. They sing it as loudly enough because they are stakeholders. So it is important to recognize that. Solidarity and loyalty jointly and individually. Now that is why for you to keep a brand, proper relationship with stakeholders, that's all. And you will see the difference. This is important. What is brand? What do we call brand? It's a perception. The picture. Yeah. Perception and the personality picture you have in the mind of stakeholders about a product, about service, about a person, or even individuals. Once they mention an Atlantic University in any circle in Nigeria, the first thing that comes to mind, that's the most expensive, yes. That's their perception. They don't even look at the value, the difference between us and any other university. But the impression is, that's the most expensive. It's only people with millions that go there. There are some private investors now who are charging almost the same thing. Yeah, and you need to know that there are some investors doing the same. Then there are some university satellite campuses charging more. Yeah, they are all over Ikeja and the BI, three bedroom universities charging more than Yeah, this determines stakeholders' action and reaction for and against. It is the perception that determines whether they support you or they don't support you. So that's why brand reputation is very key. Then, reputation and stakeholders management strategies. All these are not new to you. All of you have been doing this, so I don't need to waste my time on value chains of peculiarity. What I mean there from the last one, so all those values that School of Media Communication is giving to you as alumni, they are value, they are continuous relationship that you cannot just forget. Then you still continue with that, all through that. I don't want to waste time on your long term. When I get to where I want to make your embassy, I will do so. Yeah. The goals of strategic holder management, what are the goals? To sustain relationship for cordiality forever? Yes. High reserves of reputation capital, because it's a capital. You cannot equate it to your machinery, or your logistics, or your warehouse, because we have said that it's intangible, but it's very, very a big substance you must be sensitive about. Sustainable business growth. When you have good relationship and good reputation, you can actually have in-depth customer and breadth customer. So within the family, if generations continue patronizing you, then you become a sustainable reputation. Some of us, it was our father that introduced us to picnic. After picnic, no other milk. Just like big biro. In those days, when you ask anybody to go and buy biro, and it's not big, then if it's not Panadol, it cannot be Panadol. How many pairs are small after Panadol? Homo was like a medium to washing in Nigeria for over a year, many years, until the not area now.
Elephant.
No.
Clean.
Came all the way from Indonesia and they sponsored it. And they say it's a magic powder. Then when the slogan came in to kill it, they say yes, it's a bleach, it's a this, it's a that. Well, it sustained because. But they don't know the secret of why Clean was able to kill Puma and the elephant. It was not because of the price. It was not because it was more effective, it was because of home support. The taproot stakeholder, that is the funder, the government of Indonesia, 35% export support. So if the product costs $100, they will now sell it for $65. The government will write off 35. So while you are busy here fighting government for price control, the price has been controlled from Indonesia by the stakeholder who is the taproot. So that is what we should do. Then the last area of the, yeah, the reputational capital is important for us. So that is like I told you, it is, but I want us to look at crisis. Yeah. Understanding crisis, we all know, but we're in the crisis era, and that is why, go to the next slide. That is why it's important for us to talk about it. Anywhere you find yourself today in Nigeria as a communicator, the first priority of your employer is expecting from you is to deliver value that will either abate, prevent, or resolve crisis. Excuse me. These are just grammar about it, but we all know what crisis is about. Anything of displeasure, anything that makes you lose health balance, emotional, social, mental, organization can have mental imbalance. Thank you. If you look at it very well, bring our guests back. If we had professional communicators in the place first time, we will not find ourselves where we are. Our minister, with all respect, is far away from it. Our gentleman Okupe and Abati, well, they were, Abati was an editorial board member, not a journalist. You can claim to be one, but those of us who are called journalists, we disagree with them. If I were to manage that price tag issue, nobody among those who spoke should speak. That's number one. Because they did not understand when to talk and what to say. When to talk and what to say. If the president came, like Obama would have done on NTA, the first day he got the border saying, I can't believe it is true. 200 of my children had to go. This is crisis. You see, there are certain. Nobody was going to address anything. Then the following morning, he said, Jonathan shed tears. Paper, front page. President Jonathan cries. Can we compare the results with what we are having? I don't want to waste your time, that's why I went to the survey. You can now imagine last two crises for 9 months. Crisis is fire. If you want to resolve it, you remove the cause of fire. Fire will stop where the damage is. Fashola reduced to fees from 150 to 95,000. The students were expecting 47,500, which we were used to. So, you can see what you have seen now. Absolute peace and tranquility in the same university. Unfortunately, the crisis has wiped out very serious reputation capital for LASU.
Yeah.
Are you aware that LASU students were able to manufacture election machine, polling machine, that conducted their own election that was faultless, that was supposed to replicate throughout Nigeria? But that died in the crisis, and nobody remembered.
Wow.
That's the problem of the crisis. As communicators, I want to remind us of some. During that Jakande era, all the manufacturers of canned beer and drinks, they littered the Lagos environment. Government banned canned drinks. How many of us remember? There was a big law that once you drop a can of drink.